Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss inverses of matrices and matrix equations. We're going to do an example of finding the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. The question says to find the inverse of A equal to the matrix with entries 1, 0, 5, 3, 2, 0, and negative 1, 2, and negative 19. Let's go ahead and carefully work through this solution. So your first step is to write your matrix down again like this. Write down a parentheses, and then you write the entries 1, 0, 5, 3, 2, 0, and negative 1, 2, and negative 19. And then you draw a line. And over here, what you want to do is put the identity matrix, which is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and then 0, 0, 1. And so the goal is to make everything you see here on the left look like the identity matrix. To do that, we're going to use various row operations. And the process is as follows. We're going to start by making this number here, which I've circled a 1, which it already is. And then we're going to make the numbers below it zeros. Then we're going to make this number here, this 2, we're going to turn it into a 1 and then make the number above it and below it zeros. And then we're going to make this negative 19 a 1 and make the numbers above it zeros. We're going to work one column at a time. So since the number on the top left is already a 1, we don't need to do that. And so instead, we're going to make the numbers below it zeros. So to make the 3 a 0, we'll multiply the first row by negative 1 and then add it to the second row. We're going to do negative 3 times row 1 plus row 2. That's the operation we're going to do to turn that negative 3 into a 0. We need to make the negative 1 a 0 on the bottom here, so we just add row 1 row 3 to make that happen. All right, now we're going to perform our operations. First row is unchanged, 1, 0, 5. Then we have our line, and then 1, 0, 0. Parentheses. You can also use brackets. Okay, so we're multiplying the first row by negative 3. So this is really a negative 3 because negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. So negative 3 plus 3 is 0. 0 plus 2 is 2. Negative 15, right? It's really a negative 15 because we're multiplying it by negative 3. So negative 15 plus 0 is negative 15. Negative 3 plus 0 is negative 3. And the rest of them are the same. So we get 1 and 0 because we're multiplying by 0. So we just get 0 plus 1, which is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. Again, negative 3 plus 3 is 0. 0 plus 2 is 2. Negative 15 plus 0 is negative 15. Negative 3 plus 0 is negative 3. And the rest are the same. Adding row 1 to row 3, 1 plus negative 1 is 0, 0 plus 2 is 2, 5 plus negative 19 is negative 14, 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. Again, 1 plus negative 1 is 0, 0 plus 2 is 2, 5 plus negative 19 is negative 14, 1 plus 0 is 1, and the rest is unchanged. Now we're going to make this 2 here in the middle a 1. We're going to multiply 1 half times row 2. So keeping the first and third rows the same, we have 1, 0, 5. You draw your line, 1, 0, 0. All right, multiplying everything by 1 half here in the second row. So we're going to get 0, 1, negative 15 over 2, negative 3 over 2, 1 over 2, and then 0. Again, just basically dividing everything by 2. So we get 1, negative 15 over 2, negative 3 over 2, 1 over 2, and 0. Last row is unchanged. 0, 2, negative 14, 1, 0, and 1. Now we're going to make this, this 2 a 0. To do that, we multiply the second row by negative 2 and add it to the third. It'll be negative 2 times row 2 plus row 3. Takes a lot of practice. This takes a lot of practice to get good at. So 1, 0, 5. Keep that first row the same. 1, 0, 0. This is not the easiest example. And then negative 2 times row 2 plus row 3. So 0 plus 0. Oh, let me write down row 2. This is 0, 1, negative 15 halves, negative 3 halves, 1 half, 0. Right. Okay. So now we're ready to change the third row. So negative 2 times the second row plus the third. So 0 plus 0 is 0. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0. That was the whole point. Here it's a little bit tricky. Okay, it's going to be negative 2 times negative 15 halves. I'm going to do it on the side. Negative 2 times negative 15 halves. And we're adding that to negative 14. Okay, so it's going to be 15, right, minus 14. Oh, look at that. Just 1. Wow, right? Wow. Did not expect that to happen, right? So negative 2 times negative 15 halves plus negative 14. Did the computations up here. We got 1. Multiplying by negative 2, we're just going to get 3 plus 1, which is 4. Negative 1 plus 0, which is negative 1, and 0 plus 1 is 1. Again, multiplying the negative 3 halves by negative 2 gives us a positive 3. We add it to 1, we get 4. Multiplying negative 2 by 1 half gives us a negative 1. We add it to 0, we get negative 1, and the 1 just stays the same. All right, so now we're going to finish up. This last step is basically going to be following. So we need to make the numbers up here above this 1 zeros. We'll do negative 5 times row 3 plus row 1. So negative 5 times row 3 plus row 1. And then we're going to do 15 halves times row 3 plus row 2, right, to get rid of the 5 and to get rid of the negative 15 halves. So parentheses. Let's do this first operation. So negative 5 times the third row plus the first one. So 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. Negative 5 plus 5 is 0. That was the whole point. Draw the line. You got to keep going all the way across, right? Negative 20 plus 1 is negative 19. 5 plus 0 is 5. Negative 5 plus 0 is negative 5. Really nice. So again, we just took that third row and multiplied it by negative 5. And we're adding it to the first row again. So let me just go over that one more time. 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. Negative 5 plus 5 is 0. Negative 20, right? Negative 5 times 4 is negative 20. Plus 1 is negative 19. 5, right? It's times negative 5. Plus 0 is 5. And then negative 5 plus 0 is negative 5. And then we're doing 15 halves times row 3 plus row 2. So we have 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 15 halves plus negative 15 halves is 0. That's the whole point. Okay, 4 times 15 halves plus negative 3 halves. I got to write that one down. So it'll be 15 halves times 4, and then plus, so it's just minus 3 halves. So this is 2 goes into 4 twice. You get 30 minus 3 halves, right? So 30 minus 3 halves is 30 minus 1.5. So that's 28.5. 28.5. So this will be 28.5, right? Because you take 30, you subtract 3 halves, you get 28 and a half. And then we're doing 15 halves times row 3 plus row 2. So it's going to be negative 15 halves, okay? Plus 1 half is negative 14 halves. So that's negative 7. And then 15 halves plus 1 is 15 halves. 15 halves is 7.5. Third row is unchanged. 0, 0, 1, 4, negative 1, 1. So the answer is what you see here on the right. I'm going to write it again in white. So A inverse, ton of work. These problems are really tough. Negative 19, 5, and negative 5, 28.5, negative 7, and 7.5, and then 4, negative 1, and 1. And that would be, my friends, the inverse of this 3x3 matrix. Tons of mental computations, and you really can't show all of the work because it takes so long to do these problems. So my best advice for these problems for anyone who's watching this video is try to do it on your own now, right? Go sit down, try to do it on your own, do the best you can, and you're going to mess up. It's going to happen, but you will get better. It's normal. It's part of the learning process. Even if it feels like you're not getting better, you are getting better. It's a ton of computations. These are used to solve matrix equations, so that's one application of matrix inverses. So, and this is the hard part. This is the hardest thing. It's defining the inverse. So step one, you write your matrix down, put it in this form with the identity, and then just make this matrix look like the identity using row operations. Hopefully you've learned some math in this video, and if you have, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.